One more time. Just breathe naturally. Feel the vibration of that sound you've created within you and around you. Setting our sacred space. And then setting our intention. So in Tibetan Buddhism, they never do anything without, first of all, having a clear intention. Or motivation, cultivating a pure motivation called bodhicitta, mind of enlightenment. So that bodhicitta mind is basically thinking to yourself, by doing this action, may I become enlightened for the benefit of all sentient beings. May this action be a cause or seed of enlightenment. Results are out of our hands, but we can create the causes for our own self-realization, our own personal development, spiritual development, our own unfolding, our own awakening. So through this action of tuning into the sacred sounds, may I become enlightened for the benefit of all sentient beings. May the power of this action, may all beings be happy, may all beings be free from suffering, may none suffer. And I'll just chant the Tibetan refuge prayer and then the bodhicitta prayer in Tibetan. So if you just want to tune into the sound of this traditional Tibetan mantra or prayer. So this basically means I go for refuge to Buddha, Dharma and Sangha. I and all sentient beings go for refuge to Buddha, Dharma and Sangha. Buddha just means any enlightened being who's fully awakened and in complete harmony with the truth. Dharma is the teaching or the truth which is imparted by those enlightened beings. And the truth itself is also called Dharma, the absolute truth, which is beyond words, thoughts and expressions. So that's the medicine. So the Buddha is the doctor. The Dharma is the medicine, and the Sangha are the spiritual friends who help to administer that medicine. And Buddhists are very clear that a Buddha can appear in any religion or none, and it's not about becoming a Buddhist. Because the word Buddhist really in Tibetan doesn't exist, but they have this word Nangpa Sangye, which means inner Buddha, but it really means inner being. Someone who's following internal pathways to happiness, who's realised that happiness does not come from material things. Temporarily, yeah, temporary happiness, but then the dissatisfaction comes back and back and back. So a Buddhist is somebody that is an inner being following internal pathways to temporary and ultimate happiness. Okay, so I'll chant these prayers now. If you want to just either close your eyes or tune in the sound of this mantra. Sangye chudang sokki choknam lai jang chu padu dagni gyap suchi Dagi jin sergi pe sunam ki drola penjia sangi drupajo. Sangi chudang soki choknam lai jang chu padu dagni kepsuchi. Dagi jin sergi pe sunam ki drola penjia sangi drupajo. Sangye chudang soki choknam lai jang chu padu dagni kepsuchi. Dagi jin sogi pe sunam ki lola penje sangye drupajo. The virtues I collect by giving and other perfections, may I become a Buddha for the benefit of all. Jangchub semne rinpoche ma che panam che chuchik che pa nyampa me patang gong ne gong du pelwa sho. Semne rinpo che ma che panam che chuchik che pa nyampa me patang gong ne gong du pelwa sho. Jang chub semne rinpo che ma che panam che chuchik che pa nyampa me patang gong ne gong du pel wa sho. The virtues I collect by giving and other perfections, may I become a Buddha for the benefit of all. Setting that intention. So Tibetans will always go for refuge and then they'll set a pure intention before doing any virtuous action, any spiritual activity, or just any good deed, so that the results of that good deed are dedicated to the highest good. Not just temporary happiness, but ultimate happiness. So, you've come to relax and de-stress. So let's lie down and get ready for the gong bath. So if you want to get yourself comfortable, lying preferably on the back, either with the legs straight or with the knees bent. But if the knees are bent, have the feet slightly apart and rest the knees together. So you're not holding any tension in any part of the body at all. Let the ground take all of your weight. Place a blanket over yourself, if you have one to hand. Make sure you're not going to be disturbed. Maybe turn the phone off or silent if you haven't already. And I'm going to suggest a few pointers to help you get the most from this experience. So I'm going to say a sentence, and if you want to listen to that sentence and then repeat it to yourself if it feels right to repeat it, either mentally or you can quietly say it to yourself. So this is the guidelines for the listener. So this is a practice of listening. The Tibetans say that listening is the greatest wealth that cannot be stolen by thieves. Listening is the best way to please many people. So this is a meditation on sound, listening to sound. So let's listen to these words and repeat them if you are happy to do so. I will let the sound go right through me as though I were not there at all. I will remain open and allow the gong vibrations to immerse me without any resistance. I will keep myself relaxed and comfortable, as though I were home alone in bed. If I feel any discomfort, I will stretch or turn over without a second thought. I will let go of any urge to control anything. If I sense any time, any tension in myself, I will allow that tension to complete its cycle without judging its meaning. Sound. Notice where you feel it in the body. Experience of the sublime occurs when the judgmental mind is down. Practicing mindfulness of listening. In mindfulness, we don't judge any experience is good or bad. We don't add any commentary or analysis, any new layers of thought. We just experience the present moment, awareness of what is in that moment. slowly, take your own time. Just begin to gradually come back to the shore, from the sea, from the ocean. Sea of deep relaxation, coming back from the sound journey, back to the body, to feel the ground beneath you. Feel a sense of earth. Gradually begin to just move the body as you feel is suitable. Wiggle fingers and toes, ankles and wrists. That we need. Sometimes, even in sleep, we're not resting. We might be having crazy dreams. We might be in a bad posture. So, taking that time to press pause, to practice non-doing, conscious non-doing, very important practice. So now just bring the knees into the chest, have a little roll from side to side. Rolling maybe up and down the back if that's comfortable. Gong bath is quite a passive process, and the main body of it is just receiving, becoming receptive, which is a very important practice because the mind is always doing something. It's roaming, running, always planning something. Mind is a wonderful servant, but a lousy master. It's always trying to serve us, but sometimes not in the best way. Have this idea, have that idea. Have this worry, have that worry. Have 1,000 anxieties, because there's always something to worry about. And yet we need to come back to our true nature, our inner nature, as the seer, as the witness, as the non-doer entity. This is meditation. The true meaning of meditation is dhyan, which became the word zen when it went further east from India. The same word dhyan became chan in China, and then it became zen as it traveled further east, as the pronunciation slightly changed. This is basically a state of no mind, no thought, absolute, complete and utter thoughtlessness. Can you imagine? I'm sitting, our mind is producing 1,000 thoughts a second, some yogis have said. Certainly many, many thoughts every second. Even if we're not aware of them all, there's so many layers. Underneath all those thoughts is this still, small voice within. The one that knows, the inner being, the inner Buddha. Sometimes we need some help from sounds, such as the bowls and gongs, to arrest the mind, to give it something to focus on. But the sound itself takes us to a Zen-like state. But now we're up, we can do something together before we close. I thought this evening we could practice a Tibetan mantra of compassion, Om Mani Padme Hum. So this is the most popular, famous Tibetan mantra. The Dalai Lama is recommending everybody practices this if they're happy to. And this is invoking compassion in our own self, but also in the environment. And the energy of love and compassion is invoked by this mantra. We're opening ourselves to receiving compassion, the energy of compassion and love and healing. So we'll do the traditional Tibetan tune. So if you'd like to join in, or you can listen to the sound as another process, or meditation on sound. If you'd like to join in, it's very beneficial to do so. Let's just bring the hands together, rub the palms vigorously. So let's conclude the session now with Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Let's chant Om 3 times very slowly. And on the first Om, just think of sending love and light to yourself. Nobody else, just yourself. Bring that energy of love and light into your own body and mind as you chant Om very slowly. On the second arm, think about your family and friends and send it to those that perhaps need some extra help at the moment within your local family and friends network. And on the third arm, think about the world at large, all the suffering people that might need healing, might need light, love and reassurance at this time. And the same with the three Shantis. We'll chant Shanti as well three times. First peace mantra, it's for yourself. Inner peace, send it to yourself. Then peace to family and friends, the second one. Peace to the world, on the third one. So get ready. Take a few deep breaths. Come into meditative mode again to close the session. Deep breath in, breathe out completely. So we're dedicating our practice to inner and outer peace for ourselves, our family and friends, and the world at large. Deep breath in, deep breath out, one more breath in, and then the hands to the heart and chant on. Deep breath in. Shanti. Shanti. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Peace, peace, peace. Peace to all, love to all, light to all. Hari Om Tat Sat.